But remember the scripture in the book of James chapter 2. I think let's read that one. James chapter 2, verse number 17. Remember this one. Let's hear what Apostle James say. Apostle James chapter 2, verse number 17. What does he have to say? He says, even so, if it hath not works, your faith is dead, being alone. Do you get that? Even so, the faith, if it has no works, it is dead, being alone. So faith without works, faith without accompanying action or corresponding action is dead by itself. I've seen many believers who profess to have faith, but they don't do nothing about their faith. They just tell you, I'm believing God for big things. I'm believing God for big things. And that's the end of the story. You meet them 10 years later, I'm believing God for big things. I'm believing God for big things. Your faith needs to act. If you don't act upon your faith, nothing will materialize. Well, this is one big lacking area in many believers. We leave it in the spirit. We leave it there. We don't bring it down to reality and begin to put it to action. But I'm challenging you that as you confess your faith, as you speak your faith, put action to your words. Put action to that which you believe deep in your hearts. Take steps. Remember, the Holy Spirit is not a taker over. The Holy Spirit is a helper. He's a paraclete. Huh? He's a helper. A helper is someone who comes to your aid as you do something. As you take actions, he comes and helps you. Right. But many of us, we say, oh, I believe. I'm believing God. By this time next year, you'll see my account will be better. And there is no plan of action to making the account better. And we come next year, we begin to make do as if God is a liar or faith does not work, simply because we are missing some components in what we profess to be our faith. Now I'm challenging you. Number one, speak your faith. Number two, act on your faith. Put action to it. Put action to it. Step out in faith and begin to act on that which you profess to believe. Take action. Take action. The one whom we call our father of faith, Abraham. You see, he was a man of action. Why it was attested to him to be a father of faith is because he believed God and acted on what he believed. Right. You see, God said to him, sacrifice your son. And he said, oh, yes, I'll go ahead. I'll sacrifice him. The Bible goes ahead to say he believed that he was able even to bring him back to life. Right? So he acted in his faith. He says, he is the one who has given me. There is nothing difficult for him. He can still do it. So he acted on his faith. And in his action, God says to him, you are a father of faith. Right? In action. When you take action, when you put your faith to work, when you couple your faith, the one that you confess or profess with action, there is better results. You begin to experience results. Whenever you put action to your faith, the heavens open. God amplifies your steps.
Amen.
Ooh, do you hear what I'm saying here? When you put action to your faith, God steps in and he amplifies. You see, the miracle that we talk about when we talk about Abraham, the provision of the lamb, right? Where we have that name, Jehovah Jireh. It did not come when Abraham was in Bible school in a giving class. And they said, okay, what can we call God? Because God is a giver. And say, I think let's call him Jehovah. No. He had taken action.
Right.
The lamb was not going to be given to him when he was at home. No. The provision side of God could not be revealed until a certain step had been taken. A certain act of faith had been taken. When Abraham was willing to take an act, a step of faith to say, I'm going to sacrifice this son. I'm going to give him in obedience to God. I'm a father of nations. Yes. And I'm sacrificing this one because God has asked of him. In that moment of action, God provided. Oh, can I speak to you the right there? In your moment of action, God amplifies your actions. God amplifies you. You see, it might be small things, small tiny things. Right. But when you make that move, God amplifies. It becomes big because it's of faith. It's a step of faith. It's no ordinary step. Oh, you know the story in the book of Kings. You know it. Of those four lepers. You know the story. The four lepers. Huh? After the prophecy had been given, they were not there when the prophetic utterance was made that tomorrow by this time there's going to be plenty of food in the city. A seal of flour should be sold for a shekel. The four lepers were not there.
Right.
But they decided, because they were in the orchestrated plan of God. You see, they decided, guys, why sit we here and die? Why can't we take action? Why can't we take action? Why sit we in this situation, husband and wife? Huh? You have to discuss, honey. Why sit we in this kind of debt and die? Why sit we in this kind of problem and die? Why can't we take a move? Why can't we make an act? Why can't we take a step of faith? The Bible says, and they decided, what shall we do? Say, let's move towards where the food is.
Right.
We can't go in the city. There's nothing in there. Let's go where the food is. And they discussed and said, but the food is out there. And there is an army there. Where the food is, says, let's go there. Where the food is, we go. Let's go. Steps of faith. Are you following me?
Right.
They decided to take steps of faith. See what happens. See what happens. Because they are in the scheme of God. They are in the plan of God. But God did not tell them by angel Gabriel to say, hail you four lepers. You are in my plan. You have to go and step. No, no, no. It's a decision they had to make. Oh my goodness. Oh, many of us are waiting on God. Speak to me, Father. Speak to me. No, 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 no. Make a move. Step out in faith. I like what our father Dr. Guti said in the another video clip I watched. He said, I hear many people praying, angels come to me, visit me. He said, for what? For the why? He says in Shona, oh, it doesn't come to watch. Why do you want him to do that? Huh? You would step out in faith. Step out in faith. Step out in faith. And you will see how he will work as you step out.
Right.
The lepers stepped out and they started going. And as they were going, they did not know. Oh my goodness. They did not know that the decision they had made was a significant decision.
Right.
They did not know that their little steps that they were taking were being amplified by the host of heaven. They did not know that their seemingly insignificant steps were giant moves and giant steps in the realm of the spirit. They did not know that they were shifting levels. They were shifting dimensions by their little steps. They did not know. I'm telling you, child of God, you never know the little step you take, how much God is opening a door. You might not be aware what kind of window of opportunity that God is opening for you by a little step, by a little action. Don't look down on acting on your faith. It doesn't matter how insignificant the step might look, but every step you make in faith is amplified by heaven.
Amen.
Oh, I feel like preaching there. Every step you take in faith is amplified by heaven. So these four lepers took a step of faith and they were going. Four lepers. And I tell you, a whole army, a whole army ran away, leaving everything behind just by the sound of four lepers walking. These four lepers, can I shock you? These four lepers were not born again.
Right.
These four lepers had no privilege to be partakers of the divine nature like we are. These four lepers were not tongue speaking. They were not baptized in the. They did not speak in other tongues. But because they chose to act, stepping out in faith. See what God does. Stepping out in faith. Can you imagine? Can you fathom? How much God will open windows for you when you decide to step out in your faith. Don't wait for the opportunity to be right. Just step out in faith.
Yeah.
Don't wait for the season to be right. The Bible says the lazy will not plow because they say there is a lion in the city. And someone will not give because they are looking at the atmosphere. No. You just step out in faith.
Amen.
Walk by faith, not by sight.
Mm, mm, mm.
Do not wait for the economy to get better.
Right.
For you to start your business. Step out in faith.
Mm.
Do not wait for things to get better for you to lodge for that visa. Step out in faith.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Oh yes. Somebody saying, I'm waiting for the conditions to be favorable. I'm telling you, the favorable season, you create your own favorable season.
Right.
By your faith.
Right.
Someone is saying, I'm waiting for my boss at work to begin to treat me well before I begin to do my best at work. You are cheating yourself. You are cheating yourself. You are short-circuiting your own plan. Do your best. Put your action. Ooh. Someone is saying, I'm waiting for me to earn a little bit more money before I become more generous. You are limiting yourself. You are delaying yourself. It's your action. The action that you are going to take in faith. The action that you are going to take in faith. Will open, listen to this one, will open your next level.
Amen.
The action that you are going to take in faith will open your next level.
Eish.
Wait for the best circumstances. In the midst of that circumstance, act out of faith. Don't wait until you have a big house. A mansion, to be more organized, to be smart. don't cheat yourself. I'll be more organized when the house gets bigger. No. You are delaying yourself. The house will get bigger when you qualify by your action to get into a bigger one. In the meantime, you are limiting yourself by your action. Are you hearing what I'm saying? I will not give myself my best to this workplace because the people here don't treat me well. You are limiting yourself in the meantime. Do your very best as if you are the boss in that place. Do your very best as if you own that company. What are you doing? I'm acting in faith.
Amen.
Something coming on me here. You outgrow your present circumstances. By becoming a better you.
Right.
You outgrow your current settings by acting on a better level. I'm not sure if you got that one. You don't just step out, you outgrow it. You begin to act that outgrow the crisis.
Right.
Your actions is not determined by what is surrounding. But your faith.
Amen.
I'm challenging you today. Put some action on your faith. Don't wait for the economy to get better. Just go ahead and start that business. Don't wait for the boss to change before you begin to give your best at that workplace. Just begin to act right. You are putting your faith to work. Are you hearing what I'm saying? Don't wait until you earn more money for you to be generous. Just start right away. It's an act of faith. It's an act of faith. Don't wait for the business to grow bigger so that you begin to act professionally and offer excellent services.
Ace.
You limit yourself.
Ace.
Right there, whilst you are still operating from your house, whilst you are still operating, whilst the office is in your home, in your garage, let your services be excellent. Let your services be professional. Let your actions speak of where you want to go, not where you are. That's another one. Your actions must speak faith. Your actions must speak of where you want to go, not where you are. When we ask you the question, why are you doing the things you are doing? Your answer must not be because of what is surrounding me. If that is the answer, then something is wrong. You are not living by faith. If we ask you, why do you give the way you give? Your answer should be because I want to go higher. Why are you acting the way you are acting? Because I'm believing God for more. Not because I don't have, not because of this. No. Your present situation must not be an excuse, must not be an answer in any of your conversations.
Thank you.
If you act based on the circumstances, you have limited yourself.
Right.
I'm not sure if you got that one. If your actions are based on your prevailing situations and circumstances, you have already limited yourself. Your actions must be actions of faith. Actions of faith. When we ask you, why do you pray the way you pray? Why do you give the way you give? Why do you work hard the way you work hard? Your answer should be, I'm believing God for an open door. I'm believing God for an open opportunity. I'm believing God that this is my season. And I'm taking these steps as steps of faith.